But I would prefer to have a list a view for my thermal zones, which for which I need to click on this thermal zone tab, and that's where all these thermal zones are. You can either provide the ideal air load, which is already there in my computer. If you remember on SketchUp, we actually provided the air loads, ideal air loads to our energy model. So what is an ideal air load? Very important. Ideal air load is 100% efficient. It's always available and it has infinite capacity. People want to run the simulation with infinite capacity, 100% available and 100% efficient HVAC system to understand the heating and cooling load in their project. All right. So here you provide the air loop name. I will work on this air loop thing later. In zone equipment column, you drag and drop these zone equipments from library. You can see there are like a lot more options here. Again, unit heaters, unit ventilators, PTACs, package terminal heat pumps, four pipe fan coil, energy recovery ventilators, dehumidifier, baseboard, baseboards, and unitary system. Before we move further, let's just work on the thermostat settings. In these two columns, you provide the thermostat settings. It says cooling thermostat schedule and heating thermostat schedule. Same here with humidifiers and dehumidifier. All right. In case you want to use the multiplier, you can also do that here. What happens a lot of times in case you have a high-rise building and you just want to model three floors instead of, let's say, modeling like 40 floors, you can use the multiplier method. What you can do, you can actually create the ground floor